We are gathered here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, the joining of two hearts. In this ceremony today, we will witness the joining of Roger and Tanya. In marriage today, we have come together to witness the joining of those two lives. For them, out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary encounter. They met each other, fell in love, and are finalizing it with their wedding today. Romance is fun, but true love is something far more, and it is their desire to love each other, and that is what we are celebrating here today. But today is also a celebration for the rest of us, for it is a pleasure for us to see love in bloom and to participate in the union of two people so delightfully suited for one another, and to have a couple of cocktails. So let's get on with it already. At this time, Lisa would like to share a few things.
I have a poem that I'd like to read to you guys. You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, you've been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in the car or over a meal, all those sentences that began there, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will. Those late night talks that included, someday, and somehow, and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. Symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things you promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. Please look at each other and remember this moment. Before today, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, partner, even teacher. You've learned so much from one another in these last few years. Now you shall say a few words that take you across a threshold of life, things will never quite be the same. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. I love you guys.
A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to bed at one another. It is standing together and facing the world. It is speaking words of appreciation, demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which you can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right partner. All right, this time, face each other, please. Hold hands. Roger, please put your back. I, Roger.
I, Roger.
Take you, Tanya.
Take you, Tanya.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in love.
My partner in love.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
Love you today.
Love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Forever. I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you.
I will laugh with you.
In private.
In private.
I will love you faithfully.
I will love you faithfully.
In the best and the worst.
In the best and the worst.
Difficult.
Difficult.
And the
good.
Whatever may come.
Whatever may come.
I will always be.
As I have given you my hand to hold, as I have given you my hand to hold,
so I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
Tanya, please repeat that to me. I, Tanya. God.
Be my husband.
My partner in life.
My wife to love.
I will cherish our friendship. And love you today, tomorrow, and forever. I will trust you and honor you. I will laugh with you and cry with you. I will love you faithfully. You're the best in the world. I have given you my hand to hold, so I give you my life to you. Roger and Tanya, I would ask that you all treat yourself and each other with respect, and remind yourself often of what brought you together today. Give the highest priority to tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. When frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, as they do to every relationship at one time or another, focus on what still seems right between you, not only your partners. This way, when clouds of trouble hide the sun in your lives, and you lose sight of it for a moment, you can remember that the sun is still there. And if each of you will take responsibility for the quality of your life, together, it will be marked by abundance and happiness. Roger, you take Tanya to be your awful.
I do.
You promise to take out the trash and pick up your clothes off the floor.
I'll think about it. No, I do.
And you promise to love her even when she is hurt.
I do.
Tanya, you take Roger to be your awful wedded husband. You promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him. Promise not to whine at him when he forgets to take out the trash or pick up his clothes off the floor. And you promise to love him when he plays his game.
Good one.
Who has the ring?
I have one.
There are three rings of marriage: the wedding ring, the engagement ring, and the supper ring. We hope the ladder can be held to a minute. So the ring is changed at this time. Can you come, Roger, with it? Roger, place the ring on your left hand, wedding finger, and repeat after me. I, Roger.
I, Roger.
Take these times. Take
these times.
Be my wife. You have a soul.
I have a soul.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and health.
For richer, for poorer.
Richer, for poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
Thank you.